DOOM-cember. Okay, that was just bad. Anyways, this game is actually really well known amongst the gaming community. It was a critical and commercial success, but just like all good things, it also stirred up a lot of controversy. It wasn't the first game to be introduced to the ESRB, but it certainly added fuel to the fire. Of course, throughout the whole month of December, I'm going to be playing this extremely popular game. I guess from what I understand, a lot of people still play the original Doom, but whether that's true or not, I don't know. The very instant you hear that song, it's just none of the pure bliss. Now, like I've said in my previous streams, I'm not going to do 100% everything here because that would just take too much time. Said I'm not gonna get 100% everything here. Hang on just a second. Let me move my camera over slightly. Actually, you know, on second thought, I think it's fine where it's at. As I was saying about the controversy, many people and experts believe that a violent video game like this caused violent behaviors in the real world. I think that's just a bunch of BS, in my opinion. Although this game was really noted for the Columbine incident, where two individuals programmed their own Doom levels and decided to recreate that sort of scenario in real life. Just stupid in my opinion. I mean, there's nothing wrong with creating your own levels. I mean, that's great, but for you to do something like that, that's just pushing boundaries that shouldn't be pushed to begin with. Of course, I forgot to mention I'm playing the original DOS version of Doom. Or to be more accurate, I think I'm going to mention this in the beginning, the Ultimate Doom. Which I'll give you a little lesson on why the Ultimate Doom was being released. I guess from what I understand, the version that had three episodes was version 1.666. Figure. And so I think sometime down the road, I think, after Doom's success, it decided to release a fourth episode called Thy Flesh Consumed with really hard levels. And I think there were other tweaks. I'm not entirely sure. Just looking when they shoot each other. So I guess it literally is a every man or monster for himself. For a pecking order. Thank you. there, but that's all right. It's all good. Alright, this is going to take me to the secret level. Not exactly getting those 100%, but whatevs. Party down there, so oh yeah, I forgot the chainsaw. There we go. Whew. That was crazy. Kids. That's just the other side. Thank you. chainsawing pinkies. As in the pinky demons, of course. I'm not talking about your actual pinky. Chainsawing your actual pinkies? Really disturbing. Go. Alright. I didn't really need all that, but whatever. Okay. So from what I understand, I gotta hit a switch into the bridge up, and I'm not going down in that toxic sludge without a little pick me up. I gotta figure out how to get out of here. Uh-oh. Okay, that must be the way out. Let's go. Running. Crazy. There's our first 100. No. Nope. I never understood the purpose behind having a time and part time. I mean, if it's meant to add challenge, I guess that's a good thing. Some of the more difficult levels of episode 1. Whoops, that was not supposed to happen. Fault. Now I think I'm supposed to go into the sludge. That's the thing of beauty right there. Huh? Came from this way. Yeah, it's really easy to get lost in the later levels, and in the later episodes, where the levels not only get more complex, but you have more enemies to deal with. So episode one is more or less a, get your feet wet. Before we launch you into the, real heavy, duty stuff. So close again, that was triple 100%. So close. But, take it with a grain of salt, I guess. Thank you. Especially in a classic like this. Even starting in Doom 2, you get another spear called the Mega Spear, which gives you 200% health and armor. I don't recall if it's in this game or not. I don't think it is. Get over here. Get over here. There you go. All this room I absolutely hate. I have a good feeling I'm going to die in this room. So you need the light amplifier goggles. Looks like I got lucky here. About those barrels. They can be used to your advantage or your disadvantage. Oof, alright. What did I do? Another 100% kills. No surprise there. 89% items and 77% secrets. Alright. Getting close to beating episode 1. It would really suck at this point if I start dying. Because if you die and you don't save, you go back to the very beginning of this level, or any level you are at, and you start with pretty much nothing. Jump down there, I want to make sure. Did I miss anything? Oh, yep, I did miss something here. That's another thing I love about this game is the ambient noise. I'm telling you that there's somebody nearby. That's a very handy item, the computer area map. This was probably the biggest selling point for Doom, is having a mini-map. Which made a lot of consumers happy, because Wolfenstein 3D didn't have it. Speaking of which... It's tempting, but... I should. Use the mini-map. I mean, it's very helpful. Where am I going? Minimap or too not too minimap. Just run like heck through here. Hello, I'm new here. And there I go! First death. Ugh. Like I said, if you die, you go back to pretty much nothing. Ugh. Rough. But then again, the levels are getting tougher. Probably should have used the chain gun now that I look back. totally worth it. I have to figure out how to get out of here. Once again, totally worth it. I'm not entirely sure what this red sphere does. Partial invisibility. Huh. Not entirely sure what that does. I don't know if it reduces damage or what. Berserk item, which amplifies your fist. A really bizarre upgrade, in my opinion. Area. Good. Out of the sludge. Come on. Out of there. There you go. Oh boy. Should I get myself killed this time? Kills department. Why am I not surprised? more levels to go, and that'll be the end of episode one. Thank you. Oof. Alright. Perfect. Kills. Might as well secure. Why am I not surprised? Alright. Phobos Anomaly. Last mission of episode 1. Boss of this episode. Barons of Hell. Gotta be careful where you're positioned because you have more corners, you have barrels. Get out of the way. They're gonna appear more frequently in later episodes. As regular enemies. Supposed to die on purpose. I just love the ending of episode 1. Once you beat the big badasses and clean out the moon base, you're supposed to win, aren't you? Aren't you? Where's your fat reward and ticket home? What the hell is this? It's not supposed to end this way. It stinks like rotten meat, but looks like the lost Deimos base. Looks like you're stuck on the shores of hell. The only way out is through. Ain't that true? Alright, it's not very common for game companies to tease you or give that little dangling carrot of a hey, you wanna continue? Hey, you wanna play some more here? You wanna play some more here? Well, you gotta buy our game. Alright, and that is episode 1. Oh. Let's move on to episode 2, Shores of Hell. Like I said, throughout the month of December, I'm going to be playing Doom. It's something I like to call DOOM-cember. But of course, if I get done before the end of the month, well, then I get done before the end of December. Of course, by the time this gets posted on YouTube, it'll be long after December. Thank you. very first Cacko Demon. But it looks like there was more. I do know there's a red key here, but I don't remember where it is. Secrets. Shocker. Ah, yes, this is the Berserk item I'm talking about. Good pickup after that, too. I forgot to mention. Powerful but risky. introduction to the plasma gun. I don't really like to use this. Just in case if I ran out of options. I guess there's this. Absolutely hate this part. You don't time it right. You can get killed here. Get it, boys. Correct, I did need the right key. It was right there the whole time. Go figure. Well, the important thing is I got it. That's all that matters. I really like how the enemies instantly are aware of your presence, the very instant you step forward. These guys must have very sharp hearing. Said these guys come back in later episodes as regular enemies. That's gonna put the magic to good use. Thank you. Yeah, these guys are much harder to fight without a... without the chain gun. That was another interesting thing about Doom, is that you get to experiment with what weapons work best on which enemies. Some weapons actually surprisingly work better on others than any other weapon. Of course, that time. I think that's all I need here, so I'm just gonna move on. Not this way. Right, made it through that time. Thank you.
this way. Here we go.
Ah, boy. Oh, that wasn't so bad that time. Now I gotta be extremely careful. Soon. Oh yeah, I know in later levels you gotta be extremely careful. Because I think health kits are fewer and fewer. Now I'm stuck to all my... just my fists. Ah, this is why I wish I had the chainsaw. Yikes. Or more rather, I wish I hadn't died the first time. Unless I got one of them. This time around, third time will be the charm. Fight each other and help me conserve my ammo. That is in of itself easier said than done. And I knew this was a stupid idea to begin with. Figures. What was I thinking? Get away from me! Jeez. This is... Sakes, really? I'm gonna have to start the episode over. If this keeps up, I don't understand. Fifth or sixth try on this level alone. But like I said, levels are getting rougher. Dooms are not gonna pull any punches here, that's for sure. Like I said, if we can get them to fight with each other here, that'd be great. That's the key to survival in these later episodes. Just let the enemies fight amongst themselves. It saves you ammunition and time. Safely say I survived the skin of my teeth on that one. I better get him now. God knows what's gonna happen. I would like to know what was behind that door. Oh well. Alright. Alright, focus less on getting into fight, more about surviving. There we go. first. Okay, that wasn't so bad. Is there anything else? No. Alright, gotta go through this door now. Oh man. That's alright. It's easy to deal with. Bingo. Seems to say I'm a little more prepared, but that's not really saying much. Survivor just for what? A little dinky health boost? Oh, brother. Alright, I think I'm going to stop it here, because this is really starting to get repetitive and annoying. At least I'm just happy I got through the first episode. Alright, thanks for watching. I'll see you guys next time.